Bella Vista Community Television presents Bella Vista and Beyond. Today our host is Nancy Noyes. And our guest is Rachel Cox. And we will be talking about Tour de DeBBQ and Dress for Success. And now to the studio for our program.
Hiking, mountain biking, and recreational biking has just exploded in Northwest Arkansas, and Bella Vista is right in the thick of it. Hi, I'm Nancy Noyes, and you're watching Bella Vista and Beyond. My guest today is Rachel Cox, Executive Director of Tour de DeBBQ and Dress for Success, and she has a very exciting bike event that she would like to tell us about. Welcome, Rachel.
Thank you.
What exactly is Tour de DeBBQ?
Tour de DeBBQ is a phenomenal, fun event that we are so excited to have here in Northwest Arkansas, benefiting one of the best nonprofits that I will say, to you know, my favorite, Dress for Success. It is a charity bike ride that we have in Bentonville on June 4th that combine cycling and barbecue all on the Razorback Greenway. So it's coming up and we are thrilled to be here today to talk about it.
Excellent. Well, when does Tour de DeBBQ begin?
So the event is going to happen here in a few weeks on June 4th. And it's exciting because we are excited. This is our second year to do it. And so people can sign up and come out here in a few weeks. And we've got a lot of different rides that we'll be hosting with barbecue along the way.
So, well, that sounds really delicious as well. Yep. So where will this exciting bike ride take place?
Great question. With the Tour de DeBBQ, one of the coolest things about this ride is that we do the entire ride on the Razorback Greenway. So it starts here in Bentonville, so a little bit up the road from Bella Vista, but we have a lot of people from Bella Vista that come up for the ride, so we want everyone in Northwest Arkansas to be a part of this. But we leave from Bentonville, and it'll go down to Fayetteville and back. And so we have different distances, and we will tell more about that here in a moment, I'm sure. But it's all on the Greenway, and so different distances for different skill levels, but leaving from Bentonville, and the turnaround points will be throughout the Greenway.
Excellent. Yeah. Well, where does it exactly start in Bentonville?
Great question. I'm sorry, I should have said that a little more specifically. So this year, the ride, we moved it to Key Point Church in Bentonville is where it's starting. So if you know where Krispy Kreme is, everybody loves donuts, right? So I'm all about the food. You can talk about Tour de DeBBQ and all of this. So Krispy Kreme, right behind there is a church called Key Point Church, and they were very generous this year in letting us use their parking lot on that Saturday, June 4th. That's where we're going to start and finish the ride. It's right across from the Razorback Greenway, so easy access, and we'll have our whole setup and finish there this year.
Well, I understand that there are three different rides that bike enthusiasts can choose from. Tell us about those.
Yes. So one of the things we really felt was important was this is a opportunity for all skill levels. So we want this to be a fun day. It's not a race. It is a ride. So we have a 50 mile, a 30 mile, and a 7 mile. So whether you are adventurous and you want to get out there and ride hard for 50 miles and do that, or whether you're looking for something to just come out and have a fun day with your family for 7 miles, we've got something for all skill levels. We want it to be accessible and just let people to get out and have fun. And that's the other part of having barbecue along the way too. It's not a race, it's a ride. Some people don't eat at all. They just take it seriously and ride the whole 50 and might get something to eat at the end. And others, they'll stop every 3 to 4 miles and get a little sample of some barbecue as we go. So 50, 30, and 7 miles.
And I understand that there's kind of a contest to taste the barbecue and to vote on which barbecue is the best.
Oh, yeah. So that is something that is taken very seriously. So this barbecue concept is really neat. So we right now have 10 different barbecue restaurants throughout Northwest Arkansas that are participating. And it's really neat because the barbecue stops are set up throughout the Razorback Greenway. And every barbecue restaurant that is participating, and I'll just name a few, Wright's Barbecue, Rib Crib, Whole Hog. We have one that just came on called Girls Gone Barbecue, which is kind of cute. Smith and Betts. They give out sample size bites of whatever they want to serve. But the whole point is make your barbecue stop fun. Because when the cyclists come through, at the end, they get to vote. What was your favorite barbecue stop? And they get Cyclist Choice Award. And so everyone does it every year for their bragging rights of who won the best Tour Day barbecue stop. And so we've got 10 awesome, amazing barbecue restaurants participating this year. And someone's going to win that Cyclist Choice Award. And it's always a big, fun thing. We'll put it on our website, social media, and they get a big trophy. And so it's a pretty neat deal.
Oh, that sounds great. Yeah. Well, good for them. So how does someone register for the bike event?
Great question. They can go on our website for the Tour Day barbecue, and we have another ride in the fall too called Tour Day Tacos. So both of the registrations are on our website, tourdaynwa.com, and that will take them to our registration for that. And then also that information will be on our Dress for Success webpage as well. So we've got some things on our social media. We try to make it to where if you search for Tour Day Barbecue NWA, you're going to find it on Google. But tourdaynwa.com will take you straight there.
Great. Well, how much is the entry fee?
So the entry fee is dependent upon whether you do the longer ride or the shorter ride. It goes anywhere from $55 for the longest down to $35 for the shortest. And I'll throw this out there, too. If you're not a cyclist, you can do a sleep-in for barbecue option, too. So if you just want to support the cause and, hey, you don't necessarily want to come out and ride that morning, there's a way for you to just even just register to come and sleep in for barbecue. You can come and donate for the cause, still come get a number, and even go to the stops and get some barbecue that day, too. So there is something for everyone.
Well, that sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah.
So where does the money that is raised from this event go?
That is the best part. 100% of all of the funds go to Dress for Success, which is a nonprofit here in Northwest Arkansas. And Dress for Success is the only nonprofit in Northwest Arkansas that offers opportunities for women to be able to truly seek economic independence. And what that means is being able to help them with career services from career attire, job skills, and so forth. And so this nonprofit means a lot to me. Yeah.
I can see that it does. I think it's a very important endeavor that you're working with. So what type of women come to Dress for Success?
We work with women from all walks of life. And I think, you know, one of the most important things that I'd love to bring awareness about with Dress for Success is that some of the women that come through our doors are going through some really hard times. You know, they might be coming from shelters or domestic violence. Some of them are coming out of traumatic situations. We work with a lot of the nonprofits in our area, like recovery centers, NWA Women's Shelter, Oasis, Compassion House. But not only them, we also work with women of all stages of life. So I don't want to say that and then make anyone feel like it's just for women who are going through a rough time emotionally. Although I think all of us can relate to that. That's sometimes where we're at in life. If you're a woman who's at Walmart, for instance, and maybe you're working in the call center and you get a big promotion, but you don't have a business suit, it might be hard to go to Dillard's or JCPenney's and pay $200, $300 to get that business suit for that promotion. Our services are there to help women, no matter where they're at in life, be able to break down those barriers and get the career attire they need, interviewing skills, resume writing. you know, we have a lot of services that we provide, and I'm really grateful that we're a resource for women of all walks of life so that they can come in and get those skills.
Outstanding. Well, I know that Dress for Success does a lot more than just provide career attire. Can you tell us a little bit about what they do, a little bit more about what they do?
Absolutely. So we have two locations now, one in Rogers, which is inside the Frisco Station Mall, and now we also have a location in Fayetteville as well. And inside both, you'll find we have a technology center. So for women who may not have computers or printers, they can come in. We help them with job searches. We have career coaches. We do mentoring. We have a monthly professional women's group that teaches different job skills. And so, yes, the career attire is great because women can come in and get clothes for interviews. And then once they get the job, we give them a whole week worth, you know, of clothes, which that's awesome. But the other job skills, employer matches, we have actual employers that we can call and say, hey, we've got a woman who has these skills. Do you have something? And a lot of times we can help them find a job just right out of the bat. And matching them with other women in the community who can walk alongside and mentor them throughout their career. For a lot of women, they just really need that hand up. So it's not about a handout, it's really hand up, teaching them skills to be able to be economically independent. That's creating taxpayers in our community. I mean, it's amazing.
Exactly.
So,
well, tell us a little bit more about the mentoring program. What types of skills are taught in the mentoring program?
You know, I think mentoring looks different for each woman that comes through. So some women really need a mentor who can teach them about interviewing, per se. You know, if they're nervous about, you know, how to go about a specific interview. Sometimes it can be someone who's already gotten the job, who's, you know, been working with us. But maybe they are coming up for a promotion and they need help with figuring out what a discussion, you know, looks like. And so a mentor can really help them talk about, well, let's, you know, role play that, or hey, here was an experience that I had to navigate through some of those challenges. And a lot of times it's just walking alongside and doing life with someone. A lot of our women that come in don't have great support networks and support systems. And so for our mentors to be able to fill those gaps for our women that come in the program, it's great. So mentoring is a volunteer opportunity that we always have available and need. So if anyone's watching today, and we have tremendous volunteer options and opportunities through Dress for Success, and mentor is a great way to get involved.
So it's kind of on a one-on-one basis, right, for the mentors?
For the mentors, yes. And, you know, we also have career coaching. We have all sorts of volunteer needs. So, you know, coming in and just helping sort through clothing and making sure that we get the clothing in, you know, up and ready, and make sure it's, you know, quality donations, things like that. We've got so many ways to get people involved.
You also have a life skills class. Tell us about that.
We do. So last night was our monthly professional women's group, and that's where a lot of our life skills classes take place. It was really neat. Last night's class was on social media and how you grow your personal brand in a professional way. And so it was fun. I got to sit in on part of that last night. And, you know, every month we have a different class, and we bring in professionals from the community, and we had a wonderful speaker from Dell, the computer technology Dell.
Sure.
And I thought it was great because so many of the women that come through our door, they don't think about some of the things. Like last night, what's the first thing an employer does? They go look at your social media profile, and they're going to look at your Facebook picture and your LinkedIn picture. And so those different life skills classes, some of them are soft skills, some of them are things like what we did last night of, hey, here are some considerations you might need to be thinking about that, you know, you might not be on top of mind, but if you're going after a career, serious recruiters are going to be looking at these things. So we try to really hit it from a lot of different angles and really help equip the women that come through our doors to be thinking about things that can really help them long term.
Excellent. Well, I think that that is equally important, and that's something that not a lot of people know.
Right.
And sometimes if you look at Facebook pages, for example, you can see extremely inappropriate photographs and content, and they wouldn't want an employer to see that, I don't believe.
No. I mean, we've had classes on that and just on, you know, personal hygiene and, you know, how to make eye contact, and you know, it's really incredible how when women can sometimes come through our doors and they're just feeling deflated and they feel like maybe they don't know their worth, and they leave so much with so much more confidence, and just you can really see the transformation just in a short period of time, and that's so exciting for us to be able to see someone walk out with much more confidence and just gusto in their step, right? So it's a really amazing
exactly.
and fun. It's a fun day when we can walk out and know that we were able to watch someone walk out with some empowerment. So it's great.
Once again, where is Dress for Success located?
So two locations. Our Rogers location is in Frisco Station Mall, which is where Hobby Lobby was. Hobby Lobby just relocated. But if you know where Planet Fitness and Hobby Lobby is in Rogers, across from the Walmart on Walnut Street, that is our Rogers location. And then we have a new Fayetteville location as well, and that is in South Fayetteville on Willow Avenue. So we would love to connect with anyone who would like to come take a tour. Just give us a call, and we'd love to do that.
That sounds wonderful. Well, how can someone support Dress for Success financially?
We always would love that, right? Because that's a need, and we are 100% community supported. So we always are looking for donations. They can make a donation online, and that is on our website, which is dfsnwa.org. And they can also donate via check, which is our address, 100 North Dixieland Road in Rogers. So financially, that is a great option. And then being able to come to some of our events. So we have our cycling events this year. We'll have a gala in the fall. And we have other donation opportunities as well through some of, you know, other critical items that we need.
How can someone support Dress for Success other than financially?
Yeah, so those critical items that I was just mentioning, some of the things that, you know, everyone thinks about clothing, and that is a need. We are blessed with a lot of clothing donations, but some of the things that people don't think about that we often need are things like socks, because we need brand new socks. And so when women come in, we try to make sure that they have clothes, they have shoes, they have handbag, so accessories, handbags, but socks and underwear. We want to give them new socks and underwear, right? No, we can't give out used things like undergarments. But when we have someone who comes in from the shelter, for instance, they may be coming in with just the clothes that are on their back, or, you know, a couple of items. And so we want to make sure that we can truly give them what they need to get started in a career. And so those new type items are great. We often have a need for non-slip shoes. So a lot of our ladies that come in, they're not always going into industries that are dress suits or business suits. Some of them are in the hospitality industry. A lot of them are in healthcare. And so scrubs, we have a lot of scrubs, but they require non-slip shoes. So non-slip shoes are a huge need that we always need all sizes for.
Excellent. Well, please tell us the email again for Dress for Success.
Yes, my email is dfsnwa@dressforsuccessnwa.org. So that's a great way to connect.
Okay, wonderful. Well, I understand you have another special event coming up in September. Please tell us about that one.
Okay, so the Tour de BBQ was actually a spinoff of this event. So our initial cycling event that got it all started was the Tour de Tacos. And this Tour de Tacos event happens in September. Very similar concept to Tour de BBQ. It's where it all got started, except for it's taco stops. And We have a lot of fun. We have 13 taco stops with this, but the cool thing about Torde Tacos, it's slightly different than Torde Barbecue, is that we've added a 100-mile century ride.
Oh.
So for those in the cycling community, it's pretty big deal because it's the only century ride in Northwest Arkansas. So we'll be adding 100 miles, 62 miles, 30, and 7. So different distances, a little bit longer distances, and more tacos. Tacos versus barbecue. But we like to have fun, and it's still a really fun social day. So both of those are on that tourdaynwa.com.
So. Excellent. Well, I understand that you are, is there anything else you'd like to add?
I am just really excited to be here, and thank you for allowing us the opportunity to share. You know, for us, being able to just allow the community to know that we exist and the work that we do is really important. And having events like this help support our mission. It's important for us to just connect with the community. We have all sorts of ways for people to get involved, whether it's volunteerism, donations, and being able to just be a good community advocate. So thank you for taking time for us today.
You're more than welcome. And I understand you had a tremendous response to your Tour de Barbecue and Tour de Taco last year. How many people
Yes.
participated?
So last year was the first year for Tour de Barbecue and second year for Tour de Tacos. So last year, Tour de Barbecue initiated with over 600 riders, which was fantastic. This year, we're hoping to break that record, and so we're on our way, and so we're hoping this year to at least hit 800 riders for Torde Barbecue. And Torde Tacos last year hit over 800 riders, and so we're hoping to hit around 1500 for Torde Tacos this year. So it's really exciting. We're well on our way to hitting both of our goals this year.
Well, you must have had staggered starts so that all 1,500 people didn't go at the same time.
We did. Yes, especially because last year we were in the height of the pandemic. So we had to really plan ahead and make sure that we, you know, did this in a way that was health conscious and, you know, and made sense. So all of the different mileages start at different times. And so for the Torde Barbecue, for instance, this year the 50 mile will start at 7, the 30 mile will start at 8, and the 7 mile will start at 9:30.
Oh.
So yes, they kind of do that, but that way too, they all end close to the same time, which helps us a lot. So it's a good day and a fun day.
Did you have any trouble with people running into each other on the bicycles?
No, not really. I think the good thing about it being on the Greenway is most people have a lot of familiarity with kind of the rules of the road, we joke. But I think we've been really fortunate that our rides have so far, and knock on wood, not had really any health, problems or risk. It is a ride at your own risk also, ride, and so we put that out there. But I think over the last 3 years of doing this, we've had a couple of, minor scrapes and cuts where people who, 1 year we had a mom who accidentally bumped into her child who stopped really quickly in front of her, but it was just, a scraped knee or something. Yeah. But luckily we've been really fortunate in that way. And so we're going to keep our thoughts and prayers that's the same for this year as well. So.
Well, I think that will really work. I really do. I'd like to thank Rachel Cox for sharing with us today, Tour de Barbecue, and of course, Dress for Success. Tour de Barbecue sounds like such fun. And everyone who rides will get a taste of some great barbecue. That's the fun part, right? I believe the outstanding organization, Dress for Success, will definitely benefit from the money raised. That just about wraps it up. Be sure also to watch Bella Vista and Beyond every second Wednesday of each month on YouTube. Just go to Bella Vista Community TV and click the show you want to see. You can watch anytime. My next show will be an exciting look at the travel industry. Don't forget, we're all volunteers here and we have bills to pay. Text the word DONATE to 479 269-9426 to keep the cameras rolling. That will take you directly to the donation page. Or you can send a check to BBC TV, 1801 Forest Hills Boulevard, Suite 203, Bella Vista, Arkansas. Be sure to include your name and address, email, and phone number so we can thank you. We also appreciate the generous support of the City of Bella Vista and the Property Owners Association. We couldn't do it without you guys. Thanks to Becky Parmalee of Homestead Creation, our silver supporter. For Bella Vista and beyond, I'm Nancy Noyes. See you next time.
Remember, you can see this program on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at various times. You may also view this program on YouTube.com by going to Bella Vista TV. This has been a presentation of Bella Vista Community Television. Thank you for joining us.